In our previous class, we have done about the existence of the states of matter, and the last topic we have discussed was thermal energy. So we know, we have discussed this thing, that the thermal energy is arising due to the motion of atoms and molecules, right? So because of this, the state of matters exist. If thermal energy is low, it means that the solid is, if this matter is solid, and when the thermal energies keep on increasing, the states of matter start changing. It will change to liquid, gas, and next to plasma. So why, and we have also discussed about the existence of gas, what are the basic property of gases, we have discussed this thing. Okay, so all the gases works under four laws importantly, that is Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac law, and Avogadro law. These laws tells us about that how the changes can be done with the gases, why the gaseous form exists in nature, okay, how we can liquefy it, how we can solidify it, how the solids can directly change to the gases. So these law explains us about the existence of gases at different temperature, pressure, and volume, right? So let's just start with the Boyle's law. So Boyle was the scientist, he just explained about the gases at constant temperature. So he took the temperature as constant, the fixed, constant means fixed temperature. So he just took this thing as constant at room temperature. So for an instant, if we consider that at constant temperature, that will be a room temperature or any type of fixed temperature. So the pressure of the fixed amount of gas varies inversely with its volume, right? It's with inversely. We can say that pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. As you can see this thing in this graph, as we keep on increasing the pressure, the volume of the gas will decrease, because at constant temperature, the kinetic energy of the gaseous molecule is constant. And when we apply pressure on the gas, what will happen? The pressure binds these gaseous molecules together and liquefy it, or we can solidify it. So when we increase the pressure, the volume will decrease. When we decrease the pressure, the volume of gas will increase, because when we remove pressure or decrease pressure, the gas start expanding. It start acquiring the whole empty volume or the area of
volume badhega to gas form mein aayega
container, right? The volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Whenever the pressure increase, the volume decrease. When the volume increase, the pressure, when pressure decrease, the volume increase. Okay, so when we just remove the proportionality constant, and this is K1 is the Boyle's proportionality constant. Okay, we learn so many K's in the gases law. This was the first law proposed by the scientist about the gases, so that is why K1 is here. Okay, so P is equal to K1 upon V1. K1 is the proportionality constant. If we rearrange this formula, then PV is equal to K1, pressure volume is equal to K1, right? So let's just talk about the change in pressure and volume. If we are increasing pressure, it means we are starting from initial pressure to the final pressure, and which led to the change in volume from initial volume to the changed volume or the final volume. So if we just apply P1 on V1 volume, and after applying the pressure, what will be it will become like P2 and VT. It's like the final result. When we apply P1 then on V1 volume, then what we'll attain? We'll attain P2, the final pressure, and V2, the final volume, right? And if we rearrange the formula, that when we apply P1 pressure on V1 volume, then what will happen? We'll obtain P2. At P2 pressure, the volume V2 is there, right? So this was this type of reaction is known as isotherm. Isotherm means, iso means constant, temperature means term. When we are taking the temperature constant, this is known as isotherm. And Boyle was the scientist who explains us about the pressure volume relationship, how pressure is related to volume. So we just learn that pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. When we increase the pressure, the volume decrease. When we decrease the pressure, the volume increase. Okay, so let's just learn the Charles law. Charles law was like he just explained this thing on the basis of volume and temperature. So for a fixed mass of mass at constant pressure, if we just make the pressure constant and see the changes in volume and temperature, so what happened? The volume of the gas increasing on increasing the temperature and decreasing on cooling. When we decrease the temperature, the kinetic energy of the gaseous molecules become less, because at low temperature the gases become dense, like they just cool down, and which led to decrease in their kinetic energy. And when we increase the temperature, what will happen? After gaining the energy, kinetic energy, the gaseous molecules start vibrating. The kinetic energy led to vibration, and because of that, what happened? The volume increases. So we used to see generally that wind blows at very high speed in hot season, summer season, and we don't hear this thing that the wind storm came in winter. We used to see that in winter, winds blows, air blows, air flows, but on very less speed. Why? Because at this time temperature is low and the kinetic energy of gaseous molecules is also low, which led to the decrease in volume. And when we increase the temperature, the kinetic energy increases, which led to the moving of the particles apart from each other. Okay, so he clearly stated that when we decrease the temperature, the gas become cool, so we can liquefy it, even solidify it. Okay, and what and this is the best example, DO and perfumes, which we use to LPG, liquefied petroleum gas. That is the liquefied petroleum gas which we are using at home as fuel. So where they just cool down it, decrease the temperature, increase the pressure, and which led to the cooling, the liquefying of the gas. Okay, so what was his result when he was applying pressure? When he was applying temperature at constant pressure, they found that that of reaching increasing each degree, means when they are increasing each degree of the temperature, what has happened? The gas volume increased by 1 by 273 into 15 of original volume. So, and that too at like 0 degrees Celsius. So if you consider that at 0 degree, and at T degree temperature, the volume of gas will be at 0 degree V0, and T at T degree is VT. 0 degree is like initial, and T is the change in volume. So when just they increase the temperature, the volume changes. And after increasing 1 degree, the change is seen like 273.1.15. Okay. So if you want to write it in mathematical way, that VT is the final temperature, means on increasing the temperature, so what is the change in the volume? So first, this is the final volume. So final volume is equal to initial volume plus 1 by 273 V0. This is the change volume. So if you want to find out the what is the change in the volume, that what you have to do? You have to add the initial volume plus the changed volume. Okay, this is, so if you want to add T temperature, when they are increasing the temperature, so that temperature is T. T is just a degree of temperature, 1 degree. So when just they increase the T temperature, so what will happen? VT is equal to V naught, and they just took this V naught as constant. Isko bahar le liya as common, whole mein le liya. So that V naught is equal to 1 plus T upon 273.15. So they just seen that when they just increase 1 degree of temperature, there is a change in the volume by 1 upon 217 degrees Celsius, and this can be expressed in mathematical way like this. Okay, so what we have obtained, VT is equal to V naught, that is T. If you want to just write down the what T is, so T is equal to 273.15. This is the value of T. So temperature is what? T temperature. So what happened? T is equal to 273.15 plus the change temperature. T upon 273, they just put the value of that T here. Okay. So at this stage, we can define a new scale of temperature such that the degree Celsius, we just obtain a new scale of temperature. Previously, we heard about only the temperature can be measured in degree Celsius. But after this experiment, we came to know that there is another scale on which we can measure the temperature, that is Kelvin scale. Kelvin temperature scale, absolute scale, or thermodynamic scale. So when we are performing any reaction, when we are about to calculate the temperature of the reaction, at that time we used to use Kelvin scale. So Kelvin scale generally used in the laboratories to find out the temperature or change in temperature in the chemical when we are performing the, any chemical reaction. So if you want to find out the temperature in Kelvin, as this thing we have learned in first chapter in unit conversion, so what you have to do, you just have to add the given temperature in 273.15. And you'll got the temperature in Kelvin. Okay, so this scale was called as thermodynamic scale. So if just they remove all the entities here and put a scientific word instead of this, so T1 is equal to 273.15 T. So this T1 is they are writing in place of the above unit, that is 273.15 plus this 273.15 plus T. They are replacing this whole unit with T1. T0, we know this thing, T0 is was the initial temperature, that is 1 by 273.515, and instead of this they are writing this T0. So if we just replace all these value with the scientific terms, so what will happen, Vt is equal to V0, in bracket we are writing T1 upon T0. This is T naught is initial and T1 is final. Okay, so now we have Vt upon V1 is equal to Tt upon T0. Okay, and instead of this we can just write in terms of 1 and 2, because there is a very much confusion that which of this is initial and which of this is final. And so we know this thing, Vt and Tt is the volume and temperature when we are increasing, or change in temperature is there, and V1 or V0 or T naught is the initial one, initial temperature and initial volume before starting the reaction. So if you just write it the numbers in place of this T naught or Tt, so we can write it V2 upon V1 is equal to T2 upon T1. V2 is the final volume upon initial volume is equal to the final temperature upon the initial temperature. So what is V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. Okay, so instead of this, we just can say that this thing, that V is what? V is inversely proportional to the temperature, right? As we know this thing, that what happened, okay, if you just write it in this way, V is inversely proportional to the temperature. So what, they just replace this proportionality constant with the sign K2. So you can write this thing like this also, V is equal to K2 upon T. So this is K2 upon P. And you can write this in this way also, V upon T is equal to, this is K2. Right? So K2 is the Charles proportionality constant. So he stated that V is inversely proportional to the T, and that is equal to its constant. Right? So this can be written like this. So thus the volume of the V is equal to, you can also write it, V is equal to K2 upon T. This thing I have to just shown you on the whiteboard, is determined by the pressure of the gas, and it's about the unit of which V is expressed. So if you want to express the unit, so that is equal to the proportionality constant into temperature, the temperature which we are changing. So there is a slight change in this. Okay, then mathematical representation of the Charles law stated that pressure remains constant, means at constant pressure the volume of a fixed mass of gas is directly proportional to its temperature, means the volume is directly proportional to its temperature. As you can see this thing in this graph, there is a graph versus volume versus temperature. So when they just started from this minus 273.15 degrees Celsius, so whenever they just keep on increasing the temperature, so you can see there is a change in the pressure. When temperature is this minus 273.15, the pressure is P1. So P1 is lesser than just they increase the temperature. What happened? P2, then P3, then P4. And P4 is means the higher temperature, higher pressure you have to apply. So on higher pressure, when at what time we apply the higher pressure? When we have high temperature, because high temperature increases the kinetic energy, and to cool it down we require larger pressure to compress it. It become like quite difficult for to compress a gas or liquefy a gas at high temperature. We can compress it easily on low temperature. Okay, so each line in the volume temperature graph is isobar. We know this thing, that this type of reaction in which pressure remain constant, that type of process are known as isobar. Iso means the same, isolated, or bar means pressure. Isolated pressure means constant pressure. So the lowest hypothetical temperature at which all gases are supposed zero volume is known as absolute zero. If you want to say something, the tell a temperature at which the gases volume is zero, means gas can be liquefied easily. So that is 0 degrees Celsius.